What are we doing if we ain't moving? Hey, keeping it moving. Like, what are we doing if we ain't moving? Keeping it groovy. Hey, hey.
Yo, 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 yo. Welcome to Third Thursday. We're about to happen up in here. Thank you for joining us for this month's edition of Third Thursday.
Yep.
And today we have a visitor over here, a guy in the red jacket looking like a rock star.
Look at how I dressed up just for
Turned
you.
Up.
Wow.
I told people, call me up. I want to be there. Anyway, my name is Pastor Kevin.
Kevin Malu, the
yes,
one and only.
Mm-hmm. Man, I'm so excited to be here. By the way, you know, last time, you didn't introduce yourselves.
Oh,
we
yeah.
We just kind of saw you guys.
Really?
Yeah.
Sorry, need you.
Semeni. Semeni.
Hello, Pastor Kev.
Yes.
Yeah, this is Faith. Faith is my wife of 7 years.
Eight.
The baby's been 8 years.
We're grown-ups.
It was so fun to have her here for Third Thursday last time. We thought it might be cool for us to have a female voice. To took my boy up.
Mashagi-shagi.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Mashagi-shagi. And I'm George, if you don't know who I am. So yeah, for Third Thursday today, of course, we have our tea and chapel, as usual. Okay, guys, we've got to show you that we have... a lot of chapels. Okay, so this is how this works. Because you guys are not here and it's us guys who are here, it's just they brought all the chapels. So
for us. We miss you.
Thank you.
We miss you
as
though.
As we take everybody
we
think about you.
We're thinking about you.
That's not true. You're just enjoying the chapel.
I'm really thinking about you. Right
so
now,
for,
right now.
For our social time today, as we're having our tea, as normally it's that Thursday, we want to chat and talk a little bit.
Okay.
So our producer, she's off stage somewhere. Hey, what's up, producer? Yo. And she's gonna ask us some questions, okay? So the thing is, you have to answer the questions honestly and very quickly. It's like quick fire.
Okay.
I'm ready. You guys ready?
Okay.
All right, producer, go.
What are two things on your bucket list?
Wow.
To go to the Maldives.
Yes,
number one.
Naraka.
Yes, I have them just right here. go to Maldives and go to the moon. They're doing that, you know.
Yeah.
They're making a flight to the moon.
Yeah, now you can pay for it.
Oh, wow. Okay. Two things on my bucket list.
Yeah.
Gosh.
Mimi yang bucket list yangu naanga seasonal.
Okay.
Kwenda Mombasa.
Okay. History ya Mombasa.
Yeah, this last time it was Mombasa, this time it's still Mombasa.
Kwenda Mombasa, yeah.
Snappy, man. Quick fire.
Oh, wow. To eat ugali and nyama.
No, visit like 50 countries.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that's
yeah. Cool. Okay, I'll jump on. Can I actually,
well,
I can
my
copy.
My wife has done already 50. Just saying.
Yes,
so I'll go with you for the 50 whatever countries and then
you can come with me to Mombasa also.
Okay, there, done. Bucket list sorted.
Tell your life story in as much detail as possible in 30 seconds. George, you begin. Time starts now.
Okay. I was born. It was a cold Friday day, man. I was so black. The doctor was like, what? He's so black. And then I grew up. I went to school. I fainted when I was in class 5. Imagine, Yanni, it's Mwangi who came to help me. But it was a fake fainting, but they didn't know. And then I finished class 8. I went to high school. It was the best place. I was chapana na aswa jamu. But God ni mpoa. Man, I was kampo. Squeezing me for your job, book church.
30 seconds.
23 seconds.
Oh, wow.
All right, Faith.
I just want to say, Faith, you didn't even say got married, had kids. I just want to mention that your wife is standing right here. Brother,
don't worry.
No,
it's fine.
Baby, your life story has been
good. It's okay.
You didn't have me yours.
Let's go.
Okay, so.
All right, Faith, go.
It was a Saturday night. I was born. I'm just wanting to kill time. So then, after being born, I went to school. After going to school, I started working. I got 3 children. Okay, fine. I got married, then I got 3 children. And then I was in quarantine. And now I am here. The end.
Wow. Yeah. 18 seconds.
Wow.
You guys aren't giving details.
Okay.
All right, hang on, Pastor Kev.
Uh-huh.
All right, Pastor Kev, your time starts now.
Okay, so me and my brother were fighting in the tummy because we had two. It was like the Esau.
How cute.
And Jacob. Mm. And then I was coming out fast, then my brother pulled me, then he came, he was the firstborn, so I'm really there. And then I'm the hairy one, so that's that.
Mm.
And then we grew up. I mean, everyone was like, oh, that twin thing. I mean, we were famous all our lives, yes.
Yeah.
And we did some crazy stuff. We would exchange places, you know, play tricks on the ladies. And then, you know, all that. And then we went to high school. We went to 3 different high schools, just point to note.
Time!
What?
You're still in high school.
Yes, I have details.
Can I just point out that none of you got saved? Good life story.
Hey,
no, you're still stuck in high school. We can't visit
That's
you.
That's when I was going to get saved. Oh. I got saved in high school.
Enough to
I met
to
Jesus in high school.
Okay.
What is one thing you are very good at?
Talking.
Oh. Mm, wow. Sleeping?
Dressing. Yeah. Hey.
Yeah. Yes.
Uh-huh. Yeah. If you had to relive 1 year from school, uh-huh. which one would you do?
Easy. It is the last year of high school because that's when I got saved.
June, it's not I don't need to redo it. I'd redo class 5 in primary school.
Class 5.
Just come on, call and
I don't like the question. Why is that the answer, George? Fine. But you're not checking. I think I'd relive my second year of university. Because okay. I did so many things. I went to so many places. Yeah, that's what
That's true. Yeah. That's the same reason I'm saying class 5.
Just next question.
All right, Pastor Kev, tell us two truths and a lie and see if you're co-hosts.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Number one, we were captured by thugs, Pale Kariobangi, and then I was hit by a serious boot on my face trying to save my mother. That's number one. Number two.
That's a lie.
Yes. Number two, we've lived in more than, we've lived in 8 places up to currently right now. Number three is I went to an IGCSE school, groups of schools.
Well, okay. So do we say which one is a lie?
Mm-hmm. I think the one about 8 places is the one that's a lie.
No, I think the one for the boot and the SG, the thugs.
Yeah, they look like a hero.
Sounds too dramatic.
I totally wanted to be a hero when I was growing up.
You made it happen. You orchestrated the crime scene.
No, but that's lie. It was my brother who was hit by the boot and the thugs. I was waiting for them at home.
That's dangerous.
You are hearing the story afterwards.
Yes, I was hearing the story afterwards.
Tell us two truths and a lie.
Two truths and a lie. So the but now he'll know all of them.
I'll answer.
You'll answer. Some. Okay, so I have 3 sisters and 1 brother. And then I got thugged this year. Then the third one is I have had 3 dogs.
And the third one? The 3 dogs. Oh. It's the sisters one, eh? Because you were thugged this year. I was busy because I know you have 1 brother. Yes. How many sisters? Please forgive me. Sisters. I know you are.
Whoever that he forgot.
Whoever I forgot. Mm-hmm.
All right, my turn. Truth, and the truth.
Yeah.
Hey. Mm-hmm. Okay. I have been.
Mishkiriasana.
You're taking it wrong.
Okay.
George is just so honest.
I've been on radio like two seasons in my life. First on a program and secondly as a radio host for extended periods. Secondly, I have been a national champion of something. Mm-hmm. Okay. In my life. Number three, I have visited 4 countries in Europe.
Hey, on to Pastor Kev.
Majumi, I've known him longer than you.
This is true.
It's a good point.
Europe, 10.
Nice.
Fikiria sana.
Nafikiria. Because national champion hiyo ni ile ya John ile assembly ile alikuwa anafanyanga ile.
Mimi sikusaidi.
Unisaidi. I think it's the 4 countries in Europe.
Are you sure?
Hey, maybe it's 3 countries but not 4.
You got it.
I was just pretending. I know.
Thank you so much, Madam Producer. You can try those questions at home. We'll actually post them on our City Lights group.
That's a good one.
So you can have fun with them. Now, last time at Third Thursday, we're talking about just how to stay connected in this season. We talked about look in the mirror, so you have an honest evaluation of yourself. Mm. We talked about getting the discipline to attend to what you see, and then having staying power. You know, so you don't fall by the wayside. It's so easy to fall by the wayside. But today, we have a treat for you. Pastor Kevin, dude in the red jacket is coming, and it's going to just take a few minutes and share some quick thoughts off of what we've been hearing at church and what's going on in our world right now. So, you know, get your notebook, get your pen out, get your cup of tea or coffee or
cocoa,
bambucha,
or pineapple tea.
What is that?
Sounds healthy.
I need to introduce you.
That sounds yucky.
Very good for you. Very good.
And we'll hear the word that's coming through today.
So I just want to jump right into just what I want to share today. Just want to share a short devotional just to encourage us. I loved how George and Faith last time shared with us about staying connected, being disciplined, and having that staying power. And that's what I want to start from, that staying power. Man, the times we are living in, man, it's crazy out here. And we need that staying power as a believer. Something interesting is Pastor just finished a series about the Holy Spirit. Man, let me tell you, I can talk about this every day, all day. The Holy Spirit and how we need His help. I love the fact that the Holy Spirit is called a helper because we need that help. Brothers, I just want to tell you, I know men, we don't like saying we need help, but we need the help of the Holy Spirit. And Pastor had shared 4 points about the Holy Spirit, and I just want to connect those 4 points on how we have to conduct ourselves as believers, especially as young adults, because I feel like we're being bombarded by so many things in society right now. We're being forced to think a certain way. We're being forced to operate in a certain way. It's like you're being bombarded right, left, center. And I like one thing that George said, you know, about staying connected. He's saying it's important to stay connected, but I told him later on, I was like, it's also important to stay disconnected. There's some things you need to stay disconnected from because they just keep you in that place where, man, it's not healthy for you as a believer. So those 4 points, the first point was, the pastor's talking about is the transformation. What the Holy Spirit does, he brings transformation. In Acts 2, after Peter had shared the message of the gospel with the people that were there, they asked him, brother, what shall we do? And he told them, repent, because they needed to be transformed. Transformation is so key for us as believers. Because if we're not transformed, if our hearts are not changed, then we find ourselves kind of going back to those olden ways. You know, when I was not saved, those are way I used to do things. Those are way I used to think. Those are way I used to talk. Let me just be honest. Man, I was a foul mouth. Man, you had to like blinkly blink all my words because I was just a foul mouth. These things I used to do. And when I got saved, those are transformation. Let me tell you, the old Kev and the new Kev are two different people, and as believers, we have to be so different. In fact, I can tell you this way, we have to be dangerously different, that there has to be difference. There is difference between light and darkness. There is difference between death and life. The Bible tells us in Ephesians 2 that we were dead in sin and trespass, but when Jesus came in, He gave us life. So there has to be a transformation that changes in our lives. There has to be a transformation in how we talk, the things we say, how we think, how we conduct ourselves, especially right now with all the things that are happening on social media, with what's happening in the West, in the East, all the things that are being said and all these injustices. There has to be a difference in how we go about it. And that's what the Holy Spirit does. He brings that transformation. And can I tell you, all these things that the world is facing right now, it comes down to you need a heart change. A heart change is needed. The second thing that Pastor spoke about, the second point was purpose, focusing on purpose. I can just tell you as young people, we need purpose in our lives. If you don't have purpose, then you don't have direction. You don't know where you're going or where you're headed, or you don't wake up knowing what's the meaning of life. And this is another important thing. I feel like in our generation, there's this whole question that is never answered really well is, why am I here? What am I here for? The Holy Spirit gives us purpose. When Peter and the apostles were filled with the Holy Spirit, they had so much purpose in them. It wasn't just about fishing for fish. God gave them something bigger than themselves. And let me tell you, as a result of it, the Bible tells us, look at this man who've turned the world upside down. When you're full of purpose, there's certain things you just don't condone. the things you just don't get yourself involved in. Jesus gave us a very clear purpose. He gave us a purpose of spreading his good news, the message of the kingdom of God. Jesus was so focused on this message that so many times people would come and try and get him off of that focus. And they would tell him, hey, talk to us about this, talk to us about that. And he'd always deflect it and bring it back to the main thing. Do you know what the main thing is for you as a believer? Can you truly say you know, you have a good grasp of what the main thing is? What's your purpose? Allow the Holy Spirit to help you find purpose. Right now, people, I hear people telling me, man, Pasi, I'm so bored. A person with purpose is not bored because he has nothing but so much to do. Man, it's like get purpose in your life. COVID, no COVID, you still need purpose. There's so much for you to do in this season of your life. The next thing he spoke about, and this one, man, I'm just going to take a few moments on it. He said, focus on truth. Isn't it interesting that in the day and age we live in, our culture, that there's no absolute truths for a lot of people. There's a lot of ideas. We live in a society of ideologies. You know, it's just one idea after another, and there's no dominant one over the other. But man, it's like people don't want you to say the truth. And to be honest, even as a believer, some of the things you're tackling right now, especially on social media, because there's a lot happening there, it's like no one wants to say the truth. In fact, they want to quiet you down with the truth. And you know what the truth is? The word of God. Jesus declared, he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. There's no other else. The Holy Spirit is called the Spirit of Truth. And so many of us, man, want to say other things other than the truth. We need truth right now. And I just tell you, any society that does not align itself to the truth of the word of God, you look at it right now. It's on a slippery slope. So many, if you look at history, people who started well, who started on the foundation of God's truth, right now they've gone farther and farther away from it. And as a result, it's like night comes down to what's your truth? Not what's the truth, what's your truth? It's like now we're in an era where anyone can say anything and it's taken for truth. It's about your own opinion, about your own ideas. It's about what you think is truth, then is truth. That's why we don't even have identity. We don't even have true definitions of anything. Marriage, people don't want to define what marriage is. People don't want to define about your sexuality. People don't want to define about race and how sacred that is. It's like there's so many things and no one wants to talk about the truth. And the truth is found in God. It's found in the Spirit. That's why you need this truth. Can I challenge you on something? Before you go listening to everyone else, can you listen to the Holy Spirit? Can you take a moment and ask the Holy Spirit, what's the truth? What's the truth? What's the word? It's like we go to everyone else except the one who truly has the truth. So what's the truth? And lastly, and this one, I loved it. He talked about focusing on hope. You know, when there's an absence of truth, there's an absence of hope. Because truth is a foundation. It's what we stand on. It gives us hope. Jesus gives us hope. Man, if nothing else, he brings hope into our lives. We're living in a hopeless society. Hopeless. People are so discouraged. So discouraged. I'm talking to a lot of people right now as a pastor, calling, finding out how people are doing. And people are discouraged. Let's just be honest. People are so discouraged. No one knows what's going to happen tomorrow. No one even knows what's going to happen a few months from now. The world looks like it's erupting in chaos. It's hatred. It's anger, it's rage. It's like there's no hope. It's like you try to even talk to people about hope. It's like, man, what hope can I give you? Can I tell you the only hope is Jesus Christ? I think we need to be saying this more than ever. The only hope for humanity is Jesus Christ. He's the only hope. And the Spirit of God gives us that hope. That hope, man, that hope is needed. Man, if you don't have hope, you don't have fuel. Man, you don't have energy. You don't even wonder, why do I wake up in the morning? Why should I even come? Why should I even go from point A to point B? What's the use? Man, you need hope. And the Holy Spirit is here to give you that hope. So if you're here, you're discouraged, you're disappointed about life. You maybe don't even understand, man, as a believer, how am I supposed to go on about life? You feel like you've been suppressed, oppressed, depressed. There's hope for you today. That hope is found through the Holy Spirit. We need the Holy Ghost. That's what I wanted to leave us with. If nothing else, if you hear nothing else from me today, just hear you need the Holy Spirit. Engage. Get into that fellowship. Ask for a fresh outpouring. The Bible tells us instead of just being caught up drunk with wine, be ever filled by the Holy Spirit. That ever feeling, if you read it in scripture in the Greek, it's a continuous filling of the Holy Spirit. It's like you always need to be filled afresh by the Holy Ghost because you need Him. It's like a river coming into you, giving you life, giving you nutrients, giving you strength. We need the Holy Spirit. Let's take a few moments and let's pray. Father, I just want to thank you for this moment we've had. I know it was brief, it was direct, but I believe that it was something needed. We need the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. We need that fresh touch of the Holy Ghost. If there's ever a moment and a time in our world that we need the Holy Spirit, it is now. And I just want to pray, even according to Joel, the book of Joel, that the Holy Spirit will be poured out upon all flesh. That's the Spirit of God, the third person of the Trinity, would come and He would help us. He would teach us of the things that Jesus taught, that He would remind us, that He would show us of things yet to come. We need that comforter today. So I pray right now, wherever anyone is, that you just fill them afresh. May they just desire you for themselves as I desire you today. In Jesus' name we pray.
Thank you, Pastor Kev. That was such an awesome, awesome message, guys. I really hope, especially now when there's so much that's, you know, going on in our society, going on around us, that we take this word to heart and that we live it out. We become the Christians we need to be in this season. So as usual, we'll be continuing the discussion over on our City Lights group. For those of you who are part of City Lights, so make sure you check that out there. If you're watching and want to know how you can get in touch with NLC, please send us a message on any of our social media platforms. The Third Thursday handle, the City Lights handle are on your screen. We'd be happy to hear from you. See you next time. Thank you.